हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू रॉयल पैलेस प्यू कॉलेज ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन वी शैल स्टार्ट विद द दैट इज सॉल्यूशन ऑफ सिस्टम ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल्स। टू वेरिएबल्स मीन्स वी शैल टेक इट एज एक्स एंड वाई हियर। ओके डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सिस्टम ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स, व्हाट डू मीन बाय दिस? लेट अस टेक एन एग्जांपल। ए वन एक्स प्लस बी वन वाई ग्रेटर दैन इक्वल टू ग्रेटर दैन हियर सी वन एंड ए टू एक्स plus b to y less than c to here. Okay, fine. These two are nothing but our system of linear equations in two variables, that is x and y. Here we may have two equations or either we may have three equations also. Now here two equations, that is linear simultaneous equations. We call it as simultaneous equation, means I may have two or more equations. Okay, dear students, now let us start the exercise problems related to this particular thing. Okay, fine. Now let us begin with it. That is solve graphically. Okay, he will ask you only this part. It is a very important thing. Okay, this topic is very important, and fixed 5 marks one question will be there. 5 marks one question in your annual examination, first PUC board examination. Any problems he may ask here. Okay, fine. Now let us begin with the problem, the first one. Okay, dear students, the first one, very simple problem we'll take. It is x greater than equal to 3 and y greater than equal to 2 here. Y greater than equal to 2 we will take here. Very simple problem we will take here, first of all. Now, same as it is, we have to solve both the equations here. First of all, we have to solve both the equations. Here, last class we had seen about equation, solution of equation in two variables. It is one single equation. Here, we are having two equations that we shall see. Okay, fine. Dear student, the step one. What is the step one that we shall analyze here? The step one, that is very simple. That is, so change the equalities to inequalities to equalities. Okay, that is change inequality to equality. Okay, change inequality to equality. That is x equal to 3 and y equal to 2. These are the two equations. Now, dear students, we shall draw the graph of it. Very simple example here. We shall draw the graph of it. It is nothing but our y-axis and it is nothing but our x-axis. Now, we shall mark here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Then we shall name it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, here we may observe that x equal to 3. X equal to 3 means it is 0, 1, 2, 3. It is nothing but our point x equal to 3. And we may observe that it is nothing but greater than equal to. Greater than equal to means that is a darkened line. It is nothing but our line x equal to 3. One thing. Then we shall look on to the second line, that is y equal to 2. Here it is our second line, y is equal to 2. Now, dear students, we shall find out the solution of both the lines here. Okay, that is the, we shall shade here. Okay, I will extend here. This is our point 3 here. This is our point, that is 0, 2, and this is our point 3, 0 here. Now here, we don't require to find this point of contact here. We are not required at all to find this point of contact here. That coordinates I don't require to find here. Adre, but instead of that, okay, but instead of that, so here I will write on the solution here. Since for x equal to 3, okay, the solution region is, so what it is, it is greater than equal to. Greater than equal to means away from the origin, is away from origin. That is nothing but here x greater than 3. I will mark here like this. So in the last class I was for a single line I was shading completely, but here I will do is just I will mark here. Okay, just I will mark here. It is nothing but what it is. Solution for what it is, dear students? Solution for the x greater than equal to 3 here. Okay, away from the origin. Why it is greater than equal to means away from the origin, and less than equal to means towards the origin. Next, also for y greater than equal to 2, okay, that is solution region is, that is nothing but away from the origin again, away from origin,
away from origin. That means how it is away from the origin? In this particular manner. In this particular manner. Away from the origin. So I will mark with the separate, okay, ink pen. Now here we have to look onto the common region between these two. It is not our common region. Okay, common region for both the lines here. That is very, very important. That is common region for both the lines. We may observe that the common region for both the lines is this particular section. So therefore, here whatever the region is there, okay, that is nothing but our required solution region. Okay, so what it is? It is nothing but our required solution region here. It is nothing but our required solution region. So what I can write the answer here? Therefore, shaded region is our required solution region. Solution region or the required solution set we can talk. That means all the point coming under this section, under this region, that is nothing but our solution here. Now, dear students, one more simple CET question you may ask. That is, in this solution region, how many points may have? How many points of solution may have here? Infinite number of solutions I may get here. That is related to real numbers. Okay, dear students, this was nothing but our simple example related to this particular thing here. Now, let us move on with the second question. The second question is also very simple. Okay, let us write down the question first of all. The second one, that is x plus y greater than equal to 4. Okay, and we are having 2x minus y, okay, greater than 0. 2x minus y, it is nothing but here greater than 0. It is very, very simple thing. So before going to that, we shall solve it. Here, the problem, it is very, very simple. So first of all, step one, that is nothing but change the inequality to equality. That is, change inequality to equality. That means here, the first line will be x plus y equal to 4 here. Okay, and I will find out the points of this. Points of this means what? When x equal to 0, what will happen to y here? Y is equal to 4. When y is equal to 0, dear students, x value will be 4 here. That means the points are a of 0 comma 4 and b of what it is? That is nothing but here 4 of 0 here. First point. One thing. Then the second line. That is nothing but here. That is 2x minus y equal to 0 here. Can I write this as y is equal to 2x here? Can I write it as y is equal to 2x? That means here when I will take all the x value, that is when x, okay, and here it is y here. Okay, I will write on when x here and it is y. When x equal to 0, okay, x equal to 0, y is also 0. When x equal to 1, y is 2. When x equal to 3, 2, dear students, y is 4. When x equal to, if I take it as 3, y is 6 here and so on. If I take the negative values, dear students, negative value means if x equal to minus 1, y value will be minus 2. If I take minus 2 means the value will be minus 4 and so on. Very, very simple thing here. Okay. This is the, now depending on these particular coordinates, we will draw the graph here. Graph I will draw here. Very, very simple graph it is. Okay, this is our y-axis, dear students, and it is nothing but our x-axis. Okay, and the point 0, 0 here. Okay, and the point 0 comma 0 here. Now let us mark down the points here. Now what are the points here? Let us mark here. That is nothing but 1 2 3 4 5 6. Then here 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6, and I shall mark here also, that is -1 and then -2. Sorry, it is again -1 -2, here also -2, and so on till. Now here I will mark down the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now here what are the points? The first line, that is nothing but our AB. AB means where does it come? So here A, that is nothing but here 0, 4, that is the point A. And B, it is nothing but here B point. Now here, dear students, I will join this line here. Okay. I will join this line here. And I will extend it. Okay. I will join the line and extend it. This is nothing but our line AB. That is A is 0, 4 comes on the y-axis and 4, 0 comes on the x-axis. That means whenever the coordinates you are taking, yavaglu coordinates in irtada x, y value na irtada ili.
That means x value is 4, y value is 0. That means it comes on the x axis. If we have 0, 4, y value is 4, x value is 0, it comes on the y axis. Okay, dear students. Now here, let us move to the next step. What is the next step? The second line. The second line, we may observe that if x equal to 0, what is the y value? It is 0. Then if x equal to 1, what is the y value? It is 2. If x equal to 3, okay, if x equal to 2, y value what it is? It is nothing but our 4 here, and so on. I will mark down, dear students, I will mark down the points here. Okay, this is nothing but our line here. The similarly it will go. When x equal to minus 1, the y value will be minus 2, and so on. 1 means it is 2, y means it is 4 here. The line continues here. Okay. Now here, since what we require is, we require to find out the solution region we require to find here. Now here, we will write down, it is nothing but our equation of the straight line, and it is nothing but our straight line passing through the origin. That also we require to find here. And one more thing what we require to observe is, whenever is equal to 0 we are having, we have to make use of this particular point only. We can't solve in this particular manner. We can't find the coordinates in this particular manner. Okay, and this you will come to know in our straight line chapters, how we are doing it. Okay, now here for the line for x plus y greater than equal to 4, the solution region is, so greater than means what it is? Away from the origin, is away from origin. Okay, that is away from the origin, which is the line here, that is nothing but x plus y equal to 4. Away from the origin means this particular thing here. Just I will mark the arrow mark here, dear students, just I will do the arrow mark here, one thing. The next line comes is 2x minus y greater than 0. What it is? 2x minus y greater than 0. Or else, dear students, can write this in equation as 2x greater than y here. Okay, 2x minus y greater than 0 means y I am shifting into the RHS. 2x greater than y. Now here, which value is greater, x or y is greater than? So since here x is greater, so therefore the solution region will be towards the x-axis. This is our x-axis. Solution region will be towards the x-axis. Okay, this will be our solution region here. Very, very simple thing here. Okay, dear students, I will rewrite once again. That is for x minus, that is 2x minus y greater than 0, that is nothing but here 2x greater than y here. 2x greater than y, solution region is towards x axis. Now here one more important thing you came to learn here. What is that? That is whenever we are equating it to 0, inequality is equal to 0 or not equal to 0, what happens here? We are writing in this particular format, always the line passing through the origin here, one thing. And next, one more thing is, whichever is larger here, from this inequation, I can write as 2x greater than y. So now here, x is larger than y here. So therefore, the solution region is towards the x-axis, since x is larger. If suppose it was y greater than 3x. If y is greater than means, okay, if the opening is towards the y value, that means the solution region is towards the y axis, dear students. Okay, very, very simple thing here. Okay, one more thing. Now here, one more thing we have to observe, that the value 2x minus y greater than 0. Greater than 0 means, so here we are making use of broken lines, not the dark lines here. Broken line we have to consider. Broken line means what, dear students? That is, not consider that particular line here. Except that line, remaining all the points here. Except that particular point here. That means we are considering here only the broken line here. Okay, one thing. Now here, since we have to look onto the arrow mark here. Now here for this line, we can observe that the arrow mark is towards x-axis. And for this particular line AB, we can see that the arrow mark is to away from the origin. Now we have to choose a common region between these two. Common region means we have to look onto the arrow mark, and everywhere it is face inside here, like this. Arrow mark, it is face inside something, okay? That type of arrow mark we have to choose. If suppose you are choosing this as a shaded region, that is the solution region, then this line does not satisfy. If you are choosing this region, that means this line also doesn't satisfy. Whatever the region you are taking, it should satisfy both the lines here. Now here, dear students, you can observe that this particular region,
okay, this particular region is nothing but our feasible region. Okay, till here we have to take care. It is nothing but our feasible region. So what I can conclude is, therefore, the shaded region is our required feasible region or solution region. Okay, required solution region. Okay, dear students, it was nothing but our simple problem related to this, that is a solution of simultaneous linear equation by graphical method. These all problems are very, very important for 5 marks. Okay, dear students, now before going to the next problem, please pause the video to note it down. Okay, dear students, now let us move on to the next problem. So here also we have to solve it graphically. Graphically solving means we will write on the first step. What is the first step here? That is nothing but, that is, change the inequality sign to equality sign. That is, let, that is nothing but here 2x plus y equal to 6 here. And I will write down the coordinates simultaneously. That is nothing but here when x equal to 0. What we am taking here, when x equal to 0, what happens to y here? X equal to 0 means y equal to 6. And then here, when y is equal to 0, what happens to x here? When y is equal to 0, okay, the x value, that is nothing but 2x equal to 6, x equal to, the value will be 3, x equal to 3. So therefore, the coordinates are 0, 6, and here the coordinates are, that is nothing but here 3, 0 here. The coordinates are 3, 0. It is nothing but our for first line. Similarly, also, that is nothing but here 3x plus 4y equal to 12. That implies when x equal to 0. Okay, x equal to 0 means y value. X equal to 0 means here 0 plus what we get here 4y equal to 12. That implies y is equal to 4 ones are 4 threes are. Y value will be 3. Therefore, the coordinates are 0 comma 3. Now I am taking the coordinate point at C here. AB already is done. It is the C point coordinate. Similarly, also when y is equal to 0 here, when y is equal to 0, what we get when y is equal to 0, what we have, that is nothing but here 3x equal to 12, that implies x equal to 4 here. So here 3 ones are, 3 fours are, x equal to 4. That implies a D point is 4 comma 0 here. What we get here, dear students, the D point is 4 comma 0 here. That is nothing but our required coordinate point here, required coordinate points here. Now one thing, okay, next part is I will draw the graph here. Very, very simple graph I will draw here, dear students. It is nothing but our y-axis, it is nothing but our x-axis. In the examination, separate graph sheet will be provided for you. You have to ask the graph sheet in your examination. In that graph sheet only you have to draw the graph, as well as at the back side of the graph you can solve the problem here. Okay, every year in the question paper, question number 49A, it will be asked here, question number 49 here. Every year the same question. It is nothing but our origin, that is O. I will mark the points here. Okay, since we are having 4, 3, 6, we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I will mark the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, dear students, now let us move on with the points now. The first point is A of 0, 6. It is our point A. Okay, A of 0, 6. The second point, okay, it is nothing but our point A, 0, 6. The second point is 3, 0. It is nothing but our point B here. Okay, I will write on the at the downside B point. Now here I have to join these two lines. Okay, I will join these two lines here. Okay, that is nothing but here AB. The first line that I will write on the line, that is 2x plus y, what it is, greater than equal to 6 here. That is our first line. Or I can write equal to 6 here. One thing. I will write on the next point here. What is the next point here? We can observe that C of 0, 3. It is the point C here, 0, C. And next D of 0, 4. It is nothing but our D. I will join these two lines also. Okay, dear students. So here I am marking these two points. Okay. Now here, this is nothing but our D. I will write the equation also. The equation is 3x plus 4y, 3x plus 4y equal to 12 here. Now, the next thing is we have to write on the solution region of every line here. The first line as well as AB as well as CD here. We will write on the solution region. Okay, for 2x plus y greater than equal to 6, the solution region is the solution region where it is nothing but, okay, the for 2x plus y greater than equal to 6, here the term comes greater than equal to means away from the origin. This greater than means away from the origin, less than means towards the origin. This thing I had already explained in the last class. For that purpose, you can check onto my last class video here. Okay, that is nothing but 2x plus y equal to 6. This is nothing but our, I will mark down the points here. Okay, dear students. Everywhere we have to mark here. Not only in the first quadrant, in each and every quadrant we have to mark it wherever the line goes. Also, next here for the line, what we have for next point is that is nothing but here 3x plus 4y less than equal to 12. Okay, the solution region is, where is the solution region? The solution region is, okay, less than means what it is? Towards the origin. Dear students, it is less than, is towards the origin. Towards the origin. Why? Because it is less than. Towards the origin means where it comes? This particular section, this particular point. We have to observe here only. In the first quadrant, we can observe very clearly here. Okay, we can observe very, very clearly. Now, here, dear students, among these two lines, where is the region? Okay, that region which satisfy both the lines. We have to look onto the arrow mark. That arrow mark should be rounded here, okay, facing towards each other. Such type of region we have to find. If we are choosing this particular region, we can observe that it satisfies only this particular line, that is AB. But this line CD, it is moving towards, the solution is away towards the origin here. That means it is not our solution region. What is our solution region here is compulsory. We can observe here. It is shaded. Okay, we are having face to face the arrow mark. So here, this particular region, that is nothing but our students, the required solution region. So what I can mark here? Therefore, the shaded region is our required solution. is our required solution region. That is nothing but our required first one result here. Since we can observe that both the inequalities are, okay, less than equal to and greater than equal to, that means these are nothing but our slack inequalities. Therefore, I am having here solid line. If it was strict inequalities, then we would have, that is, broken lines here. Okay, dear students, now let us move on with the second problem, that is very, very simple, same as it is the first step. What is the first step, dear students? The first step is very simple. That is what we have to take. Let 2x minus y equal to 1 here. 2x minus y equal to 1 here, dear students. Okay. Now here, 2x minus 1 equal to 1 means when x equal to 0. What happens here when x equal to 0? What happens to y here? That we shall observe here. That is 0 minus y equal to 1. That implies y value is minus 1 here. That implies y is equal to minus 1. That I have to write here. That means what are the points here? A of 0 comma minus 1. Also, when y is equal to 0, dear students, what we have? When y is equal to 0 here, 2x equal to 1, x equal to what we have? 1 by 2 here. That implies x equal to half here. Therefore, the P point is 1 by 2 comma, that is nothing but here, 0. 1 by 2 comma 0. These are the two coordinates of this particular line. That is the 2x minus y equal to 1. Also for, that is x minus 2y equal to minus 1.
x minus 2y equal to minus 1, what we get here? That is nothing but here when, okay, what we have then, when x equal to 0, dear students, when x equal to 0, minus 2y equal to minus 1, y equal to 1 by 2, minus minus get eliminates. So what we have, y is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, the c coordinates, what are the c coordinates here? That is nothing but here x equal to 0 comma, what we have, 0 comma 1 by 2 here. Very, very simple thing, one thing. Then also when y is equal to 0, okay, when y is equal to 0, what happens here? That is x equal to minus 1, very, very simple. X minus 0 equal to minus 1 means x equal to minus 1 here. So therefore, the d coordinates are minus 1 comma 0 here. Now, dear students, the problem is very, very simple. I will draw on the graph here. I will draw the graph here. It is nothing but our y-axis as well as the x-axis. Okay, y-axis and the x-axis. I will extend our line because since we are having minus 1 also we have here. Okay, I will extend the lines here. It is nothing but minus 1, minus 1. It is our 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Since we have 1 and 1 by 2 we have, okay, still I will make the changes in the graph here. Okay, this is our x-axis, y-axis, y-dash, and next we are having x-dash. So here it is 0, here at this point will be minus 1 here, minus 1, it is plus 1, plus 2, then 1, 2, 1, 2, then we are having minus 1 here. And here we can observe that it is nothing but our point 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, here also it is minus 1 by 2, here also it is 1 by 2 here. That is point 1, point 5. Now, let us mark down the points here. The first point, that is nothing but our A. What is the point A? Coordinate A is 0 comma minus 1. Where does it comes here? 0 comma minus 1 on the y-axis. Only y value is there, x value 0 means it comes on the y-axis. That is nothing but our point A here. Okay, point A. Okay, that is minus 1 by 2 here. Next, the B point, dear students, the B point is 1 by 2 comma 0. It is nothing but here, the point B here. Okay, I will join these two lines here. I will extend the line here. One thing, the first line. Then similarly, AB is over. Next, we shall go for the CD. What is the C point here? 0 comma half here. Where is 0 comma half here? 0 comma 1 by 2. X is 0, Y value is 1 by 2. Y value is 0.5. Where does it come? It comes on the, again, Y axis. Here it is our point C here. Sorry, 0 comma 1 by 2 here, it comes here, that is a point C here. One thing, 0 comma half, positive half. Then comes the D. D value, what it is? Minus 1 comma 0. Where it comes? Here the minus D. I will join these two points here. Now let us mark down the lines here. What are the lines here? I will write down the lines here. That is x minus 2y equal to minus 1, and this particular line, what is the equation here? 2x minus y equal to 1. That is 2x minus y equal to 1 here. Now dear students, I will mark down the solution region. Where does it comes? For that is 2x minus y greater than 1. One more dear students, since it is nothing but our slack variables, okay, that is nothing but strictly inequalities, greater than, less than idaga namagena barbeku, broken lines barbeku. What we should get is the broken lines. Okay, I am marking here the broken lines. That is also very, very one of the most important thing here. Okay, we are having here the broken lines, one thing. Now that is nothing but here 2x minus y greater than, it is greater than means where it is, it comes away from the origin. 2x minus y greater than 1 means it is away from the origin. Okay, first thing, then is away from origin. Solution is away from origin, away from origin, away from the origin. And for, that is nothing but x minus, that is 2y, x minus 2y is less than minus 1, less than it is, less than 1 is what it is, towards origin. Solution is towards the origin.
okay. That means towards the origin means for this particular line, where does it comes? Here it is the origin. Okay, I will mark with different colors here. Now here, dear students, we can observe that it is very very clear that which is our feasible region that we have to opt. So now here we can observe that we can't choose this particular solution region is only for this particular line. Here this solution, this region, we can observe that it is the solution region for both of the lines here. So therefore we can say that here this particular region is nothing but our solution region here, except that particular line here, except this particular line here. Okay, whatever I am shading here, that is nothing but our required solution region here. Okay, dear students, so therefore the last conclusion is, therefore the shaded region is our required solution region, and that is nothing but our required solution, that is a graphical solution of the given simultaneous linear inequalities. Okay, dear students, now please pause the video to note down these two problems.